Hello students, today I am going to deliver lecture on the topic of linear regression, which is a topic of unit 1. The linear regression is basically a kind of supervised learning technique which is used for making the predictions of value of a continuous variable. Okay, so linear regression actually finds out the relationship between the dependent and the independent variable. Okay, and the best approximate relationship, by using the best approximate relationship, it can make the correct predictions. Okay, so one of the case is given below in this slide. Okay, here in this plot, the on the x-axis is the tutor follower, which is an independent variable, and on the y-axis is the dependent variable, which is a salary. Okay, and the blue dots are actually representing the training samples. Okay, each individual sample. Okay, by using this training sample, we find out the best approximate linear relationship. Okay, that okay, so we find out the best approximate linear relationship. Okay, so as you can see here, the black line is the best approximate line. Okay, or we can say the line which is having the least error, least prediction error, or the line of regression. Okay, so after finding out such kind of best approximate function or best approximate line, whenever we project the tutor follower on this line, then corresponding to this projected point, we can find out the correct prediction of a salary. Okay, so here the line of regression will be like this. Here y equal to mx plus c, y is the output, x is the input, and m and c are the model parameters. Okay, and we can see the parameters which that are required to be get learned through the training process. Okay, for the correct prediction, the optimized value of m and c is very much required. Okay, so in this linear regression, through training samples, we learn the correct value of m and c through the training samples. Okay, so mean square error is the error which represent the error of any line. Okay, error of any function. Okay, so here on the axis is the tutor follower and y axis is the salary, and these are the samples. Okay, so at the initial, what we will do, we don't know the correct values of the model parameters. Okay, we don't know the correct values of m and c. So what we will do, we will initialize the values randomly. Okay, let's say the we have initialized the values, and we get the line which is in the red color. Okay, so to find out whether the line is good or bad, we will calculate the error of the line. Okay, so to find out the error, what we will do, we will project every sample on this line. Okay, and then take the difference of the projected and the original value. Okay, so we will project the each and every point, a training sample point on this line, and take the difference of between the projected and the original point. Okay, so here the e1, e2, e3, e4, e5 are actually the error of every sample. Okay, then we will take the square of every sample. Okay, we will take the square of every sample. Here I have take here the square is taken because the error can be negative or the positive, and if we don't take the square, then the overall sum of the error will be the neutralize the error. Okay, so that's why the square we take the square of every error and then take the sum of all errors. Okay, then divide by the n. So this is the mean square error of a line. Okay, the line which is having the least mean square error will represent the best approximate relationship between the independent and the dependent variable. Okay, so linear regression can be multivariate. Multivariate means where the dependent variable is dependent on more than more than one variable, more than one parameter. Here the mobile price, which is a dependent variable, is dependent on the RAM size in a mobile and the number of cores in a mobile. Okay, so in this case, instead of a line, we will get a hyperplane, linear hyperplane. Okay, because here two dependent variables are there, that's why here we will get a linear hyperplane. Okay, so here this line is actually representing the slope for the RAM, and this line is actually representing the slope for the core, and this is the intercept. Okay, so equation will be like this: m1 into core plus m2 into RAM plus c. So m1 is the slope for the core, m2 is the slope for RAM, and the c is the intercept of this hyperplane, which at which the hyperplane is intercepting the line of dependent axis, dependent variable axis. Okay, so this equation will return the approximate correct value of the mobile price. Okay, so here question is arise: how to find out the correct value of m1, m2 and the c? Okay, these are the parameters that are required to be get learned through learning process. Okay, we call it the model parameters. Okay, so to find out the correct values of model parameter, we use here the gradient descent optimization technique. The task of the optimization technique is to find out the optimized values of model parameters at which the cost function is minimized. Okay, so gradient descent technique finds the correct optimized values of model parameters, okay, at which the cost function is the minimum. Okay, so we have already seen the cost function, or we can say the error function, which is the mean square error, okay, which is the correct output minus model output and the square of it, and we will calculate this for each and every sample and take the sum of all errors, and then we will divide by n. Okay, this is our cost function. Okay, so task is to minimize the cost function. Okay, so here the idea is used that we can take the derivative of this function. Okay, if we take a derivative of any function, then the derivative will return the tangent to this function. Okay, so let's say this is a cost function. Okay, and this is the model parameter m. Okay, and at the initial, we initialize the value of m randomly, so cost function will be higher at the initial. Okay, and our task is to reach at bottom of the valley. Okay, the point at which the error or the cost function is the minimum. Okay, and then we will note down the value of m at which the error is the minimum. Okay, so now how to reach the bottom of this valley? Okay, this is the problem. So to reach bottom of the valley, we take the differentiation of the cost function e, okay, with respect to m model parameter. Okay, and the derivative of this cost function will return a tangent, and if we follow the direction of this tangent for the movement in the valley, then iteratively we can reach at this point. Okay, so here I have differentiated the cost function with respect to model parameter m and the c. M is the slope and c is the intercept. Okay, so then gm is actually the derivative of cost function e with respect to m, and gc is the derivative of the cost function with respect to the intercept. Okay, so this is the output of this is the gradient of m, and this is the gradient of the c. Okay, and this is the amount by which we change the value of m and the c. Now, so this is the new value of slope, this is the old value. Okay, so to get the new value, we will add the gradient in the old value. Okay, but here we have multiplied the learning rate with the gradient. Okay, so let's see what learning rate do. Okay, So learning rate is actually a very small value that lies between 0 and 1. Okay, by changing the learning rate, we can control the amount of change in the model parameter. Okay, if we take the very high value of a learning rate, then there can be possibility that you can move down on the other side of the valley. You can move on the other side of the valley. Okay, so here three cases are given. Okay, one is this is the case where the learning rate is very high, this is the medium, and this is a very small learning rate. Okay, so the very high learning rate means the learning rate is equal to 1. Okay, so in this case there can be possibility that instead of reaching to the bottom of the valley, the model can move on the other side of the valley. Okay, so in this case the point of minimum can be missed out. Okay, so what we do, we will take a learning rate, we will multiply the gradient with the small value. Okay, so in this case the model will get converged slowly iteratively, and at the end the model will get converged. And if we take very small value of learning rate, then the model will definitely will get converged, but will take a very large number of iterations, and this will make a time taking process. Okay, so gradient descent technique, we differentiate the cost function with respect to the model parameters. Okay, and we calculate the gradients, and after finding out the gradients, we will modify the model parameters by adding the gradient in the old value. Okay, before adding the gradient in old value, we multiply the gradient with the learning rate, which is very small value, lies between 0 and 1, and that controls the learning process. Okay, so this is the whole algorithm of the linear regression. We initialize the model parameters randomly, okay, and then take the data. By using data, we calculate the mean square error. After finding out the error, we calculate the gradients, and after finding out the gradients, we modified the values of the model parameters, and this process will be repeat again and again until the model get converged. Okay, so this is the whole process of the linear regression, and that's all for the today's session. Thank you.